One of the most important and exciting things in Parshat Vayetze are two dreams. Two dreams of Yaakov. The beginning of Parshat Vayetze is the first dream. And a bit later, some 22 years later, a second dream. Now, I think all of world literature and human experience tells us that dreams are important. Shakespeare said it, "I used to think very well." We are such stuff that dreams are made of. That the dreams come from who we are. I would suggest, from what I will show you in the Bible, that that's not the case. It's very, very different. Dreams are the stuff that we are made of. It's critical for us to dream. And if we have the right dream, it's critical of us to try to put into place the dreams, the best part of us, the highest part of us. Let's look at Father Jacob. Initially, he has a dream. And Parshat Vayetze begins with that dream. He's in Beit El, the house of God. That's what the name means. He feels very close to God. And there's a ladder leading right up to heaven. And angels are ascending and descending. He dreams a magnificent dream. Truly, truly, the dreams of the Jewish people. The dream of uniting heaven and earth. The dream of a time when the two will come together. As God said to Abraham, "V'nivrichu v'cha kol mishpachot ha'adama." Through you will be blessed all the families of the earth. When we'll make the earth the kingdom of God, truly, because humankind will accept God's moral and ethical laws. That's the Jewish dream, and that's the Jewish mission. And I believe that to a great extent, Jacob leaves his father's house because he wants to bring about that dream, to go into the big world and to bring God into that world of all of humanity beyond the house of Abraham. However, the first individual, strong individual that he meets and family kinsmen is Lavan. And Lavan means white, but he was really black. In the sense of the fact that Lavan was not what he appeared to be. And Lavan was a trickster, a shyster. And Lavan was very successful, but physically, through what we would call today feile shtick, he didn't do things exactly honestly. And he played around with the genetics of the sheep. And he became very wealthy. And And Jacob stayed too long with Laban and learned too much from Laban. And then the Torah tells us that Jacob had a second dream. And this time he dreamt of spotted and speckled and striped sheep, and how to make sheep speckled or spotted or striped for your own advantage. And this second dream, he dreams only about earth, not heaven at all. Angels, the messengers between heaven and earth, do not even fit into that dream at all. Jacob's dream is very different now. He's totally Labanized. He's dreaming about the stock market. No longer about angels and God and bringing blessing to the world. And God says, I see what your dreams have done to you. I see what has happened to you. You're dreaming different dreams. And you've got to get back to your original dream, which is the dream of Abraham and the Jewish mission. So you see, it's not so much that we are the stuff that dreams are made of. Dreams must be the stuff that we become made of. We must follow our good dreams, our highest dreams, and fit into those dreams. Not make our dreams the lowest part of our beings. They have to be a dream of uniting heaven and earth, not of amassing many sheep and great wealth. And when we, the Jewish people as a whole, identify fully with the initial dream of Jacob, will bring the world to redemption. Shabbat Shalom.